Hey guys, it's Morgan coming to you with another moto vlog. We got Thomas and Ewan, and we're out here at Peach Valley. There's a ton of people out here. It's a glorious, beautiful, warm day. It's probably almost 60 degrees. And yeah, a couple things I'm trying out today, guys. We're trying out the Bulldozer ST rear and Bulldozer ST front from VeeMoto. So yeah, let's go ride. I love Peach Valley. So cool. We're gonna hit it one more time. Let's see. Anything to note? So far, so good on the tires. They all feel good. The motor feels great as always. We run it right at 410 hours. There we go. Got 410 hours on this old girl. Actually, probably more like 425. All right. We're heading into Mystery Ditch. Could be, could have some fun in here. Let's see. South you go in Peach Valley, the snowier it gets this time of year, because for whatever reason the moisture, snow seems to fall a lot thicker down south, but it won't be long before it's so dry and dusty it's gonna be out of hand. This is where it's so tough. This time of year, you gotta stay right in that rut. Yeah. Get the scoob.
Sorry, Dad.
Well, don't be sorry. Whew. Springtime in Peach Valley, guys. That mud is nasty.
Gutter
probably slanty bridge is not a good idea. Because it's going to be worse. So we can go up to the road and go back. Just take Sunset backwards over to Down Eagle. Nearly as hard as you think it is, because
I know I've been up it once, but
it's so much easier now though. It's all been cleared out. It's easier than going the other way. You heard my son protesting, but you'll see, he's gonna ride this so good, won't be a big deal at all. But it's it really does seem to work. One place I've noticed that it really works is in G-out, because a lot of times in a G-out you hit it and it tries to throw. The one thing is in a G-out, you'll hit it and your bike will rebound so hard that it tries to throw the front end all over the place. So the counter shock is kind of crazy, but it holds the front down. It's really cool, but it doesn't hold the front down so much that you can't wheelie it. Let me see, I'll find a good spot here. Here we go. Go over these rocks. And I know I say it every time I ride this bike, but I cannot believe this engine. I'm in, what am I in? Second. You can hear, you can almost count the RPM right there. We're going through this stuff, you just roll on the gas. It's crazy. It's just like a tractor. Here's a funky little spot, watch this. Nice and slow. Proud of the boys riding their small board two strokes up through that, no problem too. Thomas up there is on the 144YZ that absolutely rips. And Ewan in front of me is just a bone stock cast with others. Stock gearing and everything, so it could be a lot better. I've found that the KX's really benefit from a bigger rear sprocket. I just haven't done it yet on his. One of these days I'll get around to it. He doesn't complain, so I don't worry about it. But here's the part that Thomas doesn't like, although he's gonna go right up it. Momentum, it feels good. Pretty good traction. That is a really steep little move right there at the top. If you guys are new here, I always run nitro mousse, platinum mousses. So I've got the an NM21-220 up front, and the tires are a Bulldozer ST in the back. It's a 110-100 AT, and the front's an 80-100. I really don't like 90-100s or 90-90 tires very much. I like the skinnier front tire. It's just a personal preference. I don't think it's better or worse. I just think it works for the way I ride. Front feels good, like not pushing it, but coming down that pretty loose. We'll charge into a couple turns here and see how she does. Let the boys go a little bit. Actually, before I charge into some turns, check it out on some off camber rocks and see how it holds its edge. Got that coming up here, so. That up here, we got a little bit of off camber stuff, but here we go. I feel pretty good. Backslid a little bit. Pretty good. Back's not quite as grippy as the Force AT in the rock so far, from what I can tell. I'm excited about the knob pattern though, because it could be better in the dirt. All right, there it is. Now we're gonna go down Eagle Valley, one of our favorites. Here, I'll let the boys go. Test this front tire on some downhill loose braking. There we go. Pretty good. All right, guys, this is just kind of a cool little spot up off of Eagle Valley. Boy, it kind of went up that. Yeah, this is a pretty cool little spot to hang out. There's some rock benches over there that someone built. It's pretty awesome. Guys, took a quick little break for some snacks and some drinks. Now Thomas wants to go show me how fast he can go on the snake trail loop that we got, which is just a fast desert loop, but this should be fun. So join me as we rip around. That was fast. Oh man, that was fast. Nice work, dude. This will be the boys' first time on Sidewinder. Here we go. Sidewinder trail from Bobcat Road back. Very short little section. It's got some good rocks. This is a super fun trail, guys. If you haven't seen some of my other videos on it, it's 20 miles from end to end, and really fun. It just kind of cruises along back and forth sideways, kind of between the rim of the Black Canyon and the valley down below, down there. The Black Canyon is up to the left. That switchback. Proud of these boys. They're such good riders. These kids just don't give themselves credit. And they don't approach everything with the confidence that I think they should. So this year is going to be the year where I really push them out of the comfort zone, because they're such good riders. They can ride all this stuff. light bulbs, really. I make little mistakes like you did back there, but like, they're amazing. Yeah, dude. This is a sketchy section. Yeah. Thomas goes for it. Ha! Yeah! Yeah! See if Ewan does it. This is tough. Yeah, dude! That's all right. Good job! Good job, dude! No, I didn't mean to go down. You were doing it right. Let me... Now I gotta get up it. Fuck. Come on. I didn't make it the first try. I totally didn't make it. Had to go back down and do it again. You guys did better. Oh yeah, I'm good. Eagle Valley. Some of them follow Thomas. I don't get to follow very often. They usually stay behind both of them, but
you?
Good, yeah. We went that way a little bit, but it's so muddy we turned around.
Don't do Slanty Bridge is really bad.
Yes. Yeah, we rode Mystery Ditch right up to like to the end of it, and I'm like, I'm not going any further.
Yeah,
no, come on. We just got done. Ewan's probably done, but Thomas, I'm sure, will take you for a ride. Hey, 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 hey! That's Oscar and Otto. So they're going to ride with us down there, then you can take them on a loop.